Hey everybody, this is Dimitri Pargamonic with MarketChameleon.com. Thank you for watching. And I wanted to talk briefly about option delta. I see a lot of questions about option Greeks, and option delta is one of the most common ones that are asked about. In this example, I'm going to use Facebook options chain. So you could see that the options chain here has a lot of valuable information, including the price of each call and put option, the implied volatility of the option, the volume, and of course here I have selected the delta here to the left. And let's just pick I just picked a random month, March 15th, with 25 trading days to go. And I'm going to use an out of the money call for this example. So I selected the 175 strike. Right now, the Facebook is at 164.69, so it's $10 out of the money. This call option right now has a 26 delta. So what this means is essentially for every dollar move in the stock price, this option is expected to move up or down 26 cents for every dollar move in Facebook. So if Facebook moves up a dollar, then this option is expected to increase by 26 cents or go to $2.31. If Facebook moves down a dollar from here, then this option is expected to decrease by 26 cents or go to about $1.79 in this example. So one way to use it is, besides knowing your directional risk, is as a professional trader, you might not want to speculate on the direction of the move, but really the implied volatility. So let's say you're looking at this implied volatility and you think it's a little bit low. You could compare it maybe to the historical stock volatility for 1 year. On an annualized basis, it's moved 33.4. In the last 20 days, a 26.5 volatility. So you look at it and say, I think it's a little bit low and it should be higher. So what you would do is buy the option and hedge it. So let's take an example. You buy 10 options. So for each one option, this represents 100 shares for each option at expiration if it's in the money and you exercise it. For 10 options, that would be 1,000 shares at expiration if you exercise it and it's completely in the money. But right now it's out of the money and its delta is 26. So for 10 of these options, that represents 1,000 shares at expiration. Right now the delta is 26, so you would multiply 0.26 times 1,000, which is 260 delta. You buy 10 of these shares to hedge it, you would short 260 shares of Facebook. So if Facebook goes down by a dollar, you would make $260 on your short hedge, and you would lose $260 on your option. And if it went up a dollar, you'd lose $260 on the hedge, and you would make $260 on the option. So any $1 move or gain or loss in the option would be offset by a gain or loss in your hedge if you're perfectly delta hedged. But one way, so there are a couple ways then you could profit from this. If this implied volatility increases after the move, then you would make up a little bit more in the option than you would lose in the delta. So for this example, the stock moves down a dollar and you would make $260 on your hedge, and the option decreases, but a little bit less than 26 cents. So this implied volatility would tick up, and let's say it only decreased by 20 cents. So you would lose $200 on your 10 contracts here and make $260 on your hedge, and that's how you would make gains in an implied volatility move in your favor. Another way to profit from it is, let's say that the implied volatility is stubborn and stays the same, but the realized volatility, the volatility in the stock itself, is much higher than the implied volatility is suggesting. So I'll give an extreme example. Let's say you buy 10 of these options, you sell 260 shares to hedge it, and this Facebook drops by $20, right? So a $20 drop with your short 260 shares would net you a profit a little bit over $5,000. And let's say that this option just goes to zero because the drop was so severe, they just become completely worthless. So you would lose around a little bit over $2,000 for what you purchased it for. So as you could see, that the gain in your hedge would be much higher than the loss in your option, and that's how you would benefit from a very violent move in volatility, much more than this suggested. Another way is to actually scalp your deltas as the stock is moving back and forth. I'm going to get into that into another video, because then we have to talk about gamma first and the rate of change of your delta. But this is just one example of how to hedge off your directional risk, the directional risk in the option, and really try to isolate that implied volatility and try to make gains from the difference between realized volatility and the implied volatility. Another thing that could make the delta change besides the stock moving around is that if the implied volatility changes, that will impact the change in the delta. And as the stock gets closer and closer to expiration, then the deltas, the in the money options move closer to one delta. So at expiration, it's either going to be a one delta or a zero. So the out of the monies will move closer and closer to zero delta. So everything that's out of the money becomes worthless. It has no delta. Everything that's in the money is exercised and becomes stock and becomes one delta. So those are the things that could impact the change in the delta. And of course, as the stock moves, and crosses the strike, becomes more and more in the money, then this delta will change as the stock moves down and these become less and less in the money, then these deltas will move lower. Here we have, on the opposite spectrum, we have the puts. So the puts are the opposite of the call delta. When you buy a put option, you're actually short delta, so you'd be have a negative delta. If you sell a put, you're long delta, so it would be the reverse of the call. Hopefully this was helpful, and the next time we'll talk about more ways that you could use delta and gamma to help trade the volatility of the stock. Thanks, guys.